Good morning, dear students. In the last lecture, we studied various types of relations on a set, and we specifically studied three relations: a reflexive relation, a symmetric relation, and a transitive relation. Recall that a reflexive relation on a set A is one where every element of A is related to itself. A symmetric relation is on A is whenever an element of A is related to another element, the second element should also be related to the first. And by a transitive relation, we mean whenever a first element is related to a second and second is related to the third, then the first must be related to the third. And any relation on a set which satisfies all three, it should be reflexive, symmetric, and transitive, then it is called an equivalence relation. So in today's class, we'll take off from here. We will study equivalence classes of an element of the set under the given relation. We will also look at a few properties of equivalence classes. I will again not be proving the properties because this is something that you have done in the first year class, but I will give you an example which should motivate, at least explain why the properties work. So let's start with the definition of an equivalence class. Firstly, I need to begin with an equivalence relation on a set. So suppose R is an equivalence relation on A. Now you take any element of A. For this element, the equivalence class is denoted by bar of A or square brackets. Personally, I prefer to use the notation A bar. So I will stick to this notation. So an equivalence class of an element of the set is denoted by A bar or square bracket A and is defined as the collection of all the elements in the given set which happen to be related to A. So specifically for the element A, the equivalence class will contain all the elements which are related to A. I like to think of it as A bar is family of A. So it contains all the elements which are related to A. It's like they are all relatives of A. So all the relatives of A, the elements which are related to A, all belong to this set. So that's how we define an equivalence class. And please bear in mind that an equivalence class is an entire set. It's a set of elements. So it's not just some kind of a straightforward element. It happens to be a collection of elements. So keep this in mind whenever you're dealing with equivalence classes. Now let's understand this concept with the help of an example. So out here, I have taken an example. I've deliberately taken a finite set to begin with. So I take my set A to contain these six elements. And here, I have listed a relation on A. Recall that a relation is nothing but a subset of A cross A. So elements in R are going to be ordered pairs of elements from A. And because R is a subset of A cross A, it may not contain all the ordered pairs. It is not a very difficult exercise to prove that this is an equivalence relation on A. So if you wish to prove that it is reflexive, make sure that every single element of A is related to itself. If you wish to prove that it is symmetric, prove that whenever A is related to B, the inverse also happens. B also is related to A. And you can similarly check the transitive property by making sure that whenever A is related to B and B is related to C, then A also is related to C. So probably at this stage, it will be a good idea to pause your video. If you are convinced It's an equivalence relation. You can continue. Else, pause the video. Check whether this is an equivalence relation. And then get back to the video. So let us assume that this is indeed an equivalence relation. I do not wish to spend time over that. I would rather spend some time in finding out equivalence classes. Now I have taken a finite set, so it will be easier for me to find the equivalence class of every element in the set. Let's begin with equivalence class of 1. Recall that equivalence class of 1 will contain all elements of the set which are related to 1. So let's find out which are the elements that are related to 1. 1 surely is related to 1. I mean, 2 is related to 1. It is okay to even say that 2 is related to 1 this way because it's a symmetric relation. So if 1 is related to 2, you can be sure that 2 will also be related to 1. So another element that is related to 1 is 2. Check which other element is related to 1. Yes, 4 is related to 1. And notice that no other element is related to 1. So this will be the equivalence class of 1. It contains all the elements which are related to 1 under this relation. Similarly, pause the video and for yourselves find out what are the equivalence classes of the remaining elements of A. Once you are done with this exercise, you can start with the video again and check whether you get exactly the same elements. So I hope you have tried out the exercise. Let me now write down the equivalence class of 2. So equivalence class of 2 will contain 1 is related to 2. So 1 will be there. 2 is related to 2. And 2 is related to 4. Therefore somewhere I will also get 4 is related to 2. So and these are the only elements that are related to 2. Also, let's find the equivalence class of 3. All elements which are related to 3. 3 is related to 3. Which other element is related? 6 is related to 3. Then equivalence class of 4. Equivalence class of 4 will contain 1 is related to 4. Then 2 is related to 4. And 4 is related to itself. Then equivalence class of 5. Equivalence class of 5. Notice that 5 is related to itself and no other element is related to 5. So equivalence class of 5 will be just 5. Then we have equivalence class of 6. Equivalence class of 6 will contain 3 and 6. So this is how we find out equivalence classes with respect of any of elements of a given set under a particular relation. Naturally, if your relation changes, the elements in the equivalence class are going to change. That's obvious. We will now, based on this example, we will now list certain properties of equivalence relations. The next result that I'm going to state is very important, and these properties you will be using throughout. So let R be an equivalence relation on a set A. We start with an equivalence relation because only then we can talk about equivalence classes. Then the first property worth noting is that every element will belong to its own equivalence class. Now this is obvious. You can of course check it from the example. Look at the equivalence class of 1. It surely contains the element 1. So 1 belongs to the equivalence class of 1. Equivalence class of 2 surely contains the element 2. Equivalence class of 3 surely contains 3. So 3 belongs to equivalence class of 3. 4 belongs to equivalence class of 4. 5 belongs to equivalence class of 5. 6 belongs to the equivalence class of 6. So it looks from this example, it does look like every element is going to belong to itself. But if it, though I said we will not be proving it, think about it. Why would an element belong to its own equivalence class? Or rather, when would it belong to A bar? Now, A bar is the family of A. So it contains all relatives of A. Or it contains all the elements which are related to A. So the elements which are going to belong to the equivalence class of A are precisely those elements which are related to A. So, if I have to prove that A lies in the equivalence class of A, then I must prove that A is related to A. But then that's obvious. Because the relation is an equivalence relation, firstly it is reflexive. And therefore, every element has to be related to itself. And quite possibly there may be no other element like in this example which is related to it. But at least, that element will definitely belong to the equivalence class. Second property is, an element belongs to the equivalence class of B if and only if, again you can think about it intuitively or you can look at this example, 2 belongs to the equivalence class of 1 and look at the equivalence class of 2. Equivalence class of 2 is the same as equivalence class of 1. Look at the element 4. 4 also belongs to the equivalence class of 1. And equivalence class of 4 is the same as the equivalence class of 1. So, in general also, and 3 does not belong here. And look at the equivalence class of 3, it's not the same as equivalence class of 1. So, I can state this result in the if and only if form. A belongs to B bar if and only if A bar is the same as B bar. And if you want to intuitively think about it, then A belongs to B bar means A will be related to B. And if A is going to be related to B, family of A should be the same as family of B and the other way around. So that's an intuitive way of thinking about it. We will continue with the last two properties in the next lecture. Thank you.